Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we're going to look at an introduction to Microsoft Access. As you progress, you come to realize that most of the things you are doing in Microsoft Excel, you should be doing them in Microsoft Access. Like Microsoft Access is so good when it comes to databases. It might not be the best because as you scale up, you realize that you need to get better databases like SQL, MySQL, Postgres, and maybe the online ones like Oracle. But in this tutorial, we want to get started on Microsoft Access. And I would like to show you the very first interface when you open Microsoft Access. On this side, you have Home, which we are at home right now. Then we have New, where you can create a new blank database. Alternatively, you can click here to create a new blank database. Then on this side, we have Open, where you open your database which you had already created. Then here is the normal office staffs which you can customize them on your own. Then on the main dashboard, which, let me call it dashboard here, you have access to more templates, which if you click here and you're connected to the internet, you'll have all the templates to get started or maybe to look around. But in this video, I didn't want to show you the templates. I want to get you started on how you can use Microsoft Access. On this side, we have the recent, which shows you all the documents or the databases that you've already created. And it comes with two tabs here. We have the recent and we have the pinned, which if you just click here, if you hover around here, you can pin this item to the list. Pinning allows you to put the specified item to the very top so that you can be accessing it very fast. So if I want to pin this, I'll just click pin, and then this will appear in the pinned databases. And to unpin it, you just click here, which will unpin this item from the list, and it will be deleted and back to the recent. So let's get started by clicking the blank database. Immediately you click the blank database, it allows you to suggest or to put a name for this. And say for example, we want to create a customer's database for my subscribers. I'll click that, and then in here you have access to browse the location in which you want to store this, but I'll just let it to be in the default, which is in the documents. Then after that, I'll click create. Immediately it loads on this interface, which if you have used Microsoft Word or Excel or Publisher or other, this is the same interface but now with different functionalities. And in here by default, it has already created table. It has been good enough to create the first table, which we are going to see how to create ours very soon. Then on this interface, we have the table with the fields. In Excel, this used to be rows and this used to be columns. But in this, these are fields. So as you can see, we have this ID field, and automatically this is assigned a primary key. And maybe someone might ask, what's a primary key? A primary key is a unique identifier which prevents duplications of information in the databases. So if you have like customer and customer ID is 1, there will not be customer 1 again. On this side, table fields, as you can see from here, this is the tab that we are in. And in here we have view, which has two options, whether the data sheet or the design view. We're going to be seeing this very shortly. And these are some of the things which you are going to see and are related to this table. On the same side, if you go to home, we have the same view. And then we have copy and pasting. We are filtering. We're going to see most of these things as we progress. Since we have our table, let's proceed by putting information in our table which has already been created for us. The recommended way of dealing with this is to enter field. You come here to view and go to the design view. Then this gives you an option to say for example, we want to name it customers. Then I'll click OK, and immediately our table is renamed to customers. And here we have the field name, data type, and we have the description. On the very side, we have the property sheet, which is about the fields that we have highlighted. Like for here, I would like us to have a table where we have the customer ID. Instead of customer, let's have customer ID. Then let's have the next one. Let's have first name. Next one, let's have last name. And as you can see, automatically it's detecting the data types which we are going to save very shortly. The next one, let's have email. Next one, let's have phone, which is the phone number. Next one, let's have address. Next one, let's have city. I'm clicking the page down, or the one, the icon which shows you to go to the cell below, instead of just using mouse. The next one, let's have subscribed, because we want to see whether our customers have subscribed maybe to our YouTube channel. And I'm just doing this just to show you the functionalities in this. The next, so for instance, maybe we forgot to put some information which maybe I wanted to put just after last name and before email. So to do this, I'm going to click email, and then I'll right click, and that allows me to insert rows, and I'll write maybe date of birth, DOB, assuming this is a date of birth. See, that is the field names. The customer ID is assigned as a primary key. You can assign yours by always right clicking and clicking primary key. Alternatively, you can click this point. Then the next thing, the customer ID, let it be an auto number so that it will auto generate the number following each other. Then the first name, let's click this drop down, and we have lots of information here. The first name, we have the short text which gives us a character of 255. Then we have a longer one which gives us more text or characters. Then we have number, which are the data types which we are going to see as we proceed. So the first one, let's leave it as short text. Then we have last name, let it be a short text as well, because 255 characters is more than enough. Then we have date of birth. Date of birth, we can choose another one, which is another data type, which is date time. Then we have email, we can just write it to be short text. Then we have the phone. The phone, we can choose number as a data type. Then we have address. Address, we can put it to be short text or maybe long text, just in case someone has lots of information to fill there. Then we have city. And then the city, assuming like maybe we don't want to enter a short text, but we want it to be like yes or no, we can come here and use something like yes, no, so that maybe we want to get to know whether our customers live within our city. So if they live within the city, they can put yes or no. So maybe you can write maybe within Kenya. So assuming like that is our data, so that someone will click yes or no. Then the next one, subscribed. And maybe if we want to use yes or no, but we want to have like other options, so they will put yes or no. Then for the subscribe, maybe I want it to be like yes, no, or maybe. In that, I'll come here to short text, and then I'll go to lookup wizard, and then I'll choose, I will type in the values that I want, then I will click next. Then in here, I will say yes, because I want first option to be yes, then no, then the first one I wanted, then the next one I wanted to be maybe. Then after that, assuming that this is the options that I want, I'll click next. Then I want to limit to the list that I've typed, then I'll click finish. After that is done, I have the options to go to the description and maybe give a little more information about this, but this is optional, you don't have to. And then I can now switch back to the datasheet view, which is the view for people to view the information. I can click from here, which I showed you, data sheet, or alternatively I can go to the bottom right corner and choose between this, which is the data sheet and the design view. So this is a data sheet and this is a design view, so I can click this, and then it will tell me you must save the table first. So I'll click yes, I want to save the table now. And now as you can see, we have customer ID, first name, last name, date of birth as we put, or the variant. Alternatively, even the datasheet view, you can always double click here and you can put the information, or you can just click this down and put the data type that you want, and that will be inserted automatically. All right, then let's go ahead and create our own table. Remember, this table was created for us by Microsoft Access. To create our own table, we're going to go to the create tab, and then we're going to click table. which automatically will be listed here as table one, because table one now we renamed already. Then we can click from here, but I love changing to the design view, which I can also go in here, and then it will allow us to change the name, which I'm going to call it orders. Maybe I want to get the orders maybe from the items that maybe I am selling. Then after that I'll click OK, and after that we're back in the same view that we had before, which is the design view for the table. And in this, maybe I want the first one to be order ID, and I want it to be an auto number. Then I will write the next one. I want it to be customer ID, and I'm going to explain to you why I chose this. Then the next one, maybe I want it to be like units, which is about the units someone bought. Then I'm going to put the next one as the amount, and then maybe I can just leave it there. Then in here, I want it to be an auto number. Then the customer ID, I want it to be a number. Then the units, I also want it to be a number. I'm going to call this maybe currency. Then after that, I'm going to save this table. Then maybe I wanted the data type to be calculated, so I'm going to go to this data type and choose calculated, and this will allow me to choose from the expression categories. And I want it to be like more like an arithmetic, so I'm going to say that the amount I want it to be calculated as the units, which I'm going to double click. Then you have the options to go to the functions, but I will just choose to use the keyboard, which is shift then 8 for mine. These are the units that are produced. Then I want it to be multiplied by price, which maybe I choose to be 4, maybe this $4. Then after that I'll click OK. Then I'll click, then from here it's telling me that you cannot set amount to be to the calculated data type, so I'm going to click OK. So right after it has refused, I can just delete this row by right clicking and deleting, and then I can reinsert it back. Then choose calculated. After it's calculated, I can go back, choose unit, then multiplied by maybe $4. Then after that I'll click OK, and as you can see it has been accepted. So now I can save. Then we can go back to datasheet view by clicking here, or view and datasheet view, and as you can see we have our order ID. So we can fill our two tables from here. If I go to customers, I can double click, and after that, if immediately I put the first name, say it's J, customer ID is inserted automatically. Then last name maybe is M. Date of birth, as you can see, we have to select, and say we are born today, just to avoid lots of issues, but you can just double click and change these dates. Then say our email is j@ga.com, and then the phone number maybe 0723, just random number. Then address maybe 23 avenue. Then within Kenya I'll click yes, but you can choose yes or no or maybe. Then subscribed, you can choose whichever you want. Alternatively, you can change this to be more like, you can change the data type. If this is too repetitive, then we can change the subscribed. Maybe we can change this to be yes or no, and then after that we can go back to design to datasheet view, and then use to save this. Then as you can see now we can change it yes or no. Then this is either subscribed or unsubscribed, so I just wanted to show you the difference between the two of them. So hopefully it makes sense. Remember, you're not supposed to put information in the customer ID. That is inserted automatically. The second one is M, then W, then they were also born today, just random information, and then it's m@m.com. then the number is this, the phone number is that one, then they'll also live around there, 24 avenue, and within Kenya say yes, and they're not subscribed. We can just put information like that. You can always click enter if you're done filling the information. Then we can go to table orders and fill in information. But before we fill in information, I would like us to create a relationship of this table. So you can go to database tools, and click relationships. And once relationship comes in, as you can see from the top, from the right side, we have tables, links, queries, and all. So I'm going to be on the table side, and I'm going to choose our first table, which is customer, and our orders, because I want to create a relationship between customers and orders. And so as you can see from here, we have customer ID on both sides, which I'm going to click and drag to this customer, and that will create a relationship between the two. And then I'll click create, and now our tables have a relationship. So I can now close from here and save this relationship. Then I can come here to orders, and now I add customer. If it's customer, maybe I want customer one. They bought maybe 10 units. The amount will be calculated automatically, as you can see, because we said it will be units and the price, which the price I put it to be $4. I can change this amount to currency if I want to, but this is not for today. And you can always go back and say also customer 2 bought 30 units and this will be 120, and this is what you get. Say for example we wanted to get maybe the sum totals, we can click totals, and in here we have 160. You can always change this to sum to an average and get 80, and the maximum you get 120. Anything else you can calculate from here. So that's how you can do it. To remove this, you can click it totals back. You can always change the bold, underline, font, and everything from there, but I just wanted to rest at that because this is just a beginner tutorial. The next thing we're going to see is how to create a form. And to create a form, we're going to go to create, and then you click form wizard. It's better to, since we're a beginner, we're going to use a form wizard, which I'm going to click the customer first, then I will click form wizard, and this will allow me to choose this the information that I want. You can click here one by one, but the best, and if you want to remove it, you can click this and take it back, but the best is just to click this, select everything, and take it over the other side and just remove maybe the customer ID because we don't want that one, and take it back. Then after that you can click next. I want it to be a columnar. You can choose the others, and just to see how it will look like, I'll choose to use the columnar, then I'll click next. Then after that you can rename the way you would like it to be. Say let it be form. Then after that I will create, open the form to view or enter information. Then after that I'll click finish, and immediately we have our customer form here. So we have first name, which was jmj@j.com, and all the information that we have here. You can always go back to design view or the layout view if you want to see how it looks like. And this, the design view allows you to change different aspects, like maybe if you didn't want this, you can change this from customers to customers info. You can change it from here, or you can change it, once you click it, you can always change it here. Let me just bring this. You can change it here, or you can change it here in the caption. You can change the font color even by clicking here, or going to change the font size and the font color from here. You can move this around. If it changes to this yellowish or orangish color, you can move it to where you would like it to be. Then of course, like this is a text box, you can select like this and move it, and once you move it, it moves as a pair. But if you want to move it one by one, you should be clicking this gray. The gray allows you to move it independently, and this allows you to move it as a pair. So this is something that maybe I wanted to let you know. If maybe I want to change this, I can come here to this format, the back color, and change all from here. Alternatively, I can just choose to just use this and maybe choose the green one, and this changes the way the form looks like. Now I can go back to form view, and that's how my table looks like. If I want to maybe to add some buttons here, I can go to design view, and in here in the form design I have have these options which I can add so many things from here. But one of the things maybe I wanted to show you is a button. So I can click a button, and that allows me to place the button where I would like it to be. Say for example, I want it to be somewhere like here. This brings a command button wizard which allows me to select the action that I want the button to do. Say from the record, I have record navigation which has this, all these records. I have record operations which adds new records. Say for example, maybe I wanted to add a new customer. I can click add new record and click next. But before that, you can also delete records. You can do cross form. You can reprint current form, print a form. You can go through all these options, but I just wanted to maybe create like maybe one, maybe for adding a record, then I'll click next. Then after that, I want it to be from text, which will write add record. You can change this to be anything that you'd like it to be, but I'll click add record. Then after that, click next. Then the best thing, you can leave it to be command 17, but the best thing will be writing a name which you can refer to it later. And after that, I'll click finish. As you can see now, we have add record here. I can go back and create another, which is more, I'll just draw it here. So in this, maybe I would like it to be for going to maybe the next record. Then I click next, then allow it to be a text, let it be a text. Then after that, click next. Then I'll say next record. Then after that, I'll click finish. If you don't like maybe the color of this, you can change it from here, which is the format, or you can go back to home tab and change the color from here. Say maybe I want it to be like a greenish one, and then that will be done. So just to show you like the functionalities of this, I can change the view back to form view. So I can add information like maybe E and then G, then date of birth, let it be also today, then the email, let it be e@e.com, then the phone number, let it be like that, then the address, 43 Sib Avenue. Then are they within Kenya? I can say no. Then subscribed, maybe yes. Then after that, I can click add record. So just to verify whether record is added, I can go back to customers and refresh this table and click refresh all. And as you can see, now we have E, G, and these are the information. So our form is working really well. The next one is to how to create a report. So to create a report, since we are doing a beginner lesson, we're going to go to create, then we're going to go to the report wizard, which will open report wizard, which you can create report from more than one table. So maybe I wanted to get a report of first name, then last name, then maybe a phone, email and phone. Then I also wanted to include orders. Then I wanted to have units and then the amount. I can click next. This opens a report wizard, which asks you whether you want to view your data by customers or by orders. Say we want to view by customers. I'll click customers. Then after that, I'll click next. We have options to sort by first name and last name, then maybe by phone. And then you can click next. Then in here you can choose amount, and then after that, ascending or descending. Then maybe you can click summary options just to see next. You can click next. Then after that, whether you want the layout to be stepped or block, as you can see from here, or the outline. I'll go for stepped or block, it's good for me. Then for the orientation, I'll just choose portrait. I can click this to adjust the field width so that all the fields fit on a page. Then after that, I'll click next. Then the title of the report, I will rename it to be customers report. Then we can preview or modify the report, but I'll choose preview the report. Then I'll click finish. Then this is our customers report. From here, we can see the first name, last name, phone, and the email of our customers, and so on. So this is basically the beginners to Microsoft Access. We're going to dive deeper into this. So these are some of the basics that you can do with Microsoft Access. Of course, there are so many things which you're going to deal with as we progress, as maybe like external data. You can always get data from Excel or other places like databases, online services, and other sources. You can export your data maybe to Excel, and that allows you to choose the destination where it will be saved. And if you click OK, that will be saved in the selected destination as Excel sheet. So this is just a beginner tutorial, and I'm looking forward to seeing you as we progress with deeper tutorials on using Microsoft Access. I hope that you've learned something, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in the next video as we expand the knowledge of Microsoft Access. I'm hoping to see you in the next one. Until next time, bye bye.